Arnold Roland Jr. was the pastor of the Church of the Nazarene that led me to the Lord, lo, these many years ago, as a young adult. In his ministry in various churches, he always had at least one, and sometimes two, young people in the church who felt a call from God to be preachers, to prepare for ministry. I was one of those. He very much focused on God's call and what God could do through a person who was trained and willing to be used. He did not mention the pastors who could not leave their homes during the day because their wife was working so that they could afford to be the pastor. He did not mention the parsonage I lived in, where the upstairs floor didn't quite meet the thresholds of the bedroom doors, and in fact bowed like this. Anybody listening just gonna have to guess. Which happened at least to match the ceiling of the dining room down below. He did not mention the sorts of things that our pastors had to go through all along, and today we want to start talking about some of those things. But rather than the anecdotes, and all of you have far more anecdotes than I do, we've got some gathered statistics that I'm sharing with you. I trust you picked up this sheet. I thought this would be easier than trying to jot down whatever numbers I toss out in the next few moments. Since the green bar across the top of the page shows the actual reported income from all of our local churches, for all of our local churches, since 1975. You can see that it just looks like we were doing great until the mid-2000s. And in fact, since 2007, we've had a 13% drop in reported income. But you see that little yellow line, orangish line, or whatever color that is? Let's convert that into inflation-adjusted dollars. We've had a 24% drop in purchasing power over the last decade for our local churches. That's got to affect pastors. It also affects indebtedness. We have less debt today than we had then. It hasn't dropped quite as drastically, but it has dropped. Mainly, it looks like, because we didn't go into new debt rather than really being able to pay off the old. But there is less debt in the Church of the Nazarene today in the U.S. than there had been previously. But the equivalent purchasing power, I thought was also interesting to note, that we now have the equivalent purchasing power in 2015, the last year we have full data for, to the purchasing power we had in 1984. Now, you can buy different things. You couldn't buy a cell phone for love, money, nor marbles back in 84, but you could buy food and gas and lodging for about today what you could then in equal purchasing dollars. So that's the church picture. What about the ministers themselves? We took a survey this spring for other purposes, but we're able to use this data to inform this group, which is good. And here's where the numbers just start flowing. We had pastors respond to the question, what's your income? And the median income for pastoral households is $75,000, which is a lot better than if you ask the churches what they're paying them. In fact, if you ask the churches what they're paying them, they're paying about $40,000 a year. You ask the pastors what they're being paid, the median is $44,000. Partially, the churches is lower because they don't always have pastors the full part of the year. Not surprisingly, 40% of our pastors in an annual report tell us that they are, in fact, bivocational. Sometimes it's because it's absolute necessity financially. Sometimes it's because they can expand their ministry opportunities. That's fine, but it's still bivocational and needs to be taken into consideration when figuring out what a church can afford. 44% of the pastors report additional income themselves. That is, they earn additional income. This may not be that different than the 40% reported bivocationally in the annual reports, because some income may be retirement, investment, other sources of income that don't require you to set a certain number of hours aside, so you don't feel like you're bivocational. But 44% of the pastors have additional income besides that which the church provides. 68% of the pastoral households have at least some income from the spouse coming in as well. So if our pastors are able to pastor our churches, it's not because the churches are paying them well enough, it's because they have other sources of income. It is the case that 10% of our pastors, 10% of USA pastors, have no other income than that which the church provides. Interestingly, a larger percentage, 12%, don't get any church income. We have more volunteers in pastoral ministry than we have actually earning all their household income from the church income. Preparedness. With this financial situation, we asked the pastors, how are you doing health-wise? Nearly all our pastors have health insurance. Pastors and families have health insurance today, usually through other employment rather than through the church. How many are prepared for retirement housing? About two-thirds feel like they are. About 34% say they are not, which matches pretty closely to the fact that 31% of our churches provide their pastors a parsonage. 46% own parsonages, but 15% of that 46 don't use them for the pastor. So about one-third of our pastors are in parsonages, and it kind of matches how many are not prepared for retirement when housing is mentioned. One-fourth of our pastors are not prepared for financing their children's education. When you take in that 40%, this doesn't apply to because they don't have children, or they don't have them yet, at least when they filled this out, that's a pretty substantial group. 36% are not prepared at all for their retirement finances. That's the pastors. Associate ministers, median household income, $68,000, with the median being $30,000 from the churches. Likewise, 37% report additional income themselves. That makes them bivocational. 20% receive no church income, which makes them volunteer, but they're still ministering. How well are they prepared? Nearly all, again, have health insurance, usually either through other employment or the family purchased their own health insurance from a plan. Again, one-third not prepared for retirement housing. The other two-thirds already own a home. 33% are not prepared for financing their children's education, and 43% are not prepared for retirement. That's a current look at how our pastors and associates feel about their own financial preparedness, where their income is coming from, how well the churches could even think of financing with a 24% drop in purchasing power in the last decade. That will be a challenge for many churches. And being back at the 1984 level of purchasing power has got to be a challenge. I have scads more details I could be sharing with you, but we wanted to get to some solutions instead of painting the picture. If you have specific questions, I will be here this afternoon. Feel free to ask, drop a note, however you want to do it. Write to research@nazarene.org, and we'll look up anything we can for you.